this time the focus is as slowly as you can do it. So it holds you in a one-leg stand longer. Since once again, the point of Tai Chi in the water is core strength and balance more than anything else. And there's a lot of strengthening that happens too in the process. It's really about core strength and balance. So I'm going to do it slowly, balancing in that one leg stance, and our brains will still get happy, but in a different way than if we do it like we do in the other class fast. Now let's go backwards. Skip hop backwards. This time the leg reverses, and you step behind you as you skip on the leg that's under you. And your arms are relaxing at your side, your cheeks stay soft, your jaws are dropped. And I just feel my brain getting happy. Well, first of all, because we're in warm salt water. Why not, right?
Why not?
Yeah. So nice and slowly backwards. And the skip hop is not a form, but it is very much like the crane form, which we will do next in walking. And then we'll do the wave hands on clouds in walking. So we can turn any of the standing forms into a variation in walking. There we go. Good. You're doing great. I hope that feels good on your sore foot. Now here we're going to go into the crane, and I'll get in front of you again.
Okay.
The crane you do, you've only been in one class, I think, so you probably don't remember the crane, but the crane, your arms become wings, and as you step forward slowly, you bring your wings together to touch as the foot goes down, and then you bring your arms back as you're advancing the other foot, and bring the other foot down slowly as the hands are wings. Remember that. You're now moving like wings. Think about a beautiful white crane, which you've seen, and you can visualize that. And if you've ever seen the slow motion crane mating dance, the Siberian cranes, it's the most beautiful and weird thing in nature, I think, or one of. So beautiful movements of cranes. They're like nature's ballerinas. So think about that as we move our arms and legs ever so slowly. And now we'll go back with wave hands like clouds. And for this, I will be facing because you're going to go all the way down, and you're going to be starting on your left foot, same foot as me, so we don't have to mirror image.
Okay.
And the wave hands like clouds, the left hand is on top, on the right side of your body, at about the same as holding the ball of light that we do in the roll back and press. So now as you step left, slowly, you bring your hands in front of you, they'll be together, and then you bring it to the left as the right hand is on top and the right foot steps in. And then you start coming back to the middle as the left leg is slowly reaching out, and you're moving your hands like clouds in the sky or clouds in the water. Fish make clouds in the water, they lay eggs. They tussle up some sand. So we're making clouds in the water. And we have our knees soft and bent. We are waving our hands like the clouds as we move, staying on one leg for a great deal of the time. So this is an excellent balance activity. And we're alternating arms and legs, which is a very normal way that we humans move. To be upright, to balance ourselves, we have to be swinging on when we walk, it's our opposite arm that swings. And as my left leg advances, my left hand is on top on the right side. Coming back, it doesn't have to be exact, but it will. It will fall into line because it feels more natural that way. This is a beautiful knees, but the muscles on both sides of the joints are working. and your core is working, and your balance systems are all working, your inner ears, your brain, your muscles, your tendons, everything is working to keep you in position. So appreciate that. You have a whole team working for you to stay in one position. Because guess what? The water wants to move you. And you're not going to have it. Okay, now shift back to the left. Arms at side. Slowly lift that right foot. Knee comes up. Slowly bring your foot back to the other foot. Shift to the right. And now slowly lift the left foot. Feel the wonderful reactions that your body is having. Really appreciate it. Arms at your side. Bring your arms up in front as you go down into your knees. As we do the commencing form, left foot out. And this just feels so nice. Be aware of the softness in your shoulders and in your face and in your head as you're just lined up. Standing posture. Everything working. Breathing through your nose in and out through your mouth. Now this is the last one. Bring your hands back to your side. Shift to the right foot fully, lifting the left heel, lifting the toes up high and stepping in to the right foot. You are now back to the point where we will shift to the left foot, lift the right foot, and now turn the right toes to the steps. Check your stance. You should be in a V stance. Now shift to the right foot, take a short step forward on the left. Now you're in an open. You're open about like this, and now we're going to do the push, which is hands like this under the water, and you rotate, or not rotate, you just shift 70% of the weight in the front, 30 still on the back, and now you go back to the back being 70, the front is 30, and the toes are up as the hands come back, and as the hands push forward, in a circular movement, you go to the full flat on the left foot and you're on the toes of the right foot. So when you do the 70-30, you shift whichever foot is not full weight bearing to either toes or heels and your arms are corresponding to it. And you can feel how well that sinks together. Making circles and you're keeping your back straight and you're breathing and relaxing in your upper body. And then we do a few without me talking. Down to your sides, lift your toes as you pass them, step back with the left, turn the right toes in, check your stance that they're under your hips, shift on your heels so that your left toes are facing the left steps,